Thank you very much, Chair Nadler and Ranking Member Jordan, members of the committee. To Representative Bass, thank you for your incredible leadership on this issue. First, we at the National Urban League strongly support the passage of the Justice in Policing Act. And to Mr. Floyd and Ms. Underwood-Jacobs, I join in sharing our thoughts and our prayers with you on your losses. Your courage is admirable. Thank you very much. Between 1882 and 1968, that's an 86-year period, 4,742 people, mostly black, were lynched in the United States. These murders were turned into public spectacles, with people being tortured, mutilated, and burned in front of hundreds of spectators mocking their deaths. In 1922, the United States House of Representatives had the courage to pass a bill to make lynching a federal crime. However, white supremacists in the United States Senate filibustered that bill and blocked 200 attempts to pass that bill, a blockage which continues to this day in the United States Senate. Imagine if in 1922, the Congress of the United States had demonstrated the courage to make lynching a federal crime, how many of those 4,742 people would not have died? Today, we look at most recent history, and we see from 1954 to 1965, dozens of civil rights activists were murdered, including the four little girls at that Birmingham church in 1963. But this Congress, in 1964 and 1965, this Congress with bipartisan majorities and the courage of a Southern president who had previously supported segregation, demonstrated the courage and the conviction to pass the 1964 Civil Rights Act, the 1965 Voting Rights Act, and the 1968 Fair Housing Act. Since 2013, when Trayvon Martin was killed in Florida, 1,291 black people have been shot and killed by the police. Over 100 of them were unarmed. And now, in 2020, as we stand just 6 years away from the 250th anniversary of this nation, before the eyes of the world, George Floyd was lynched on the streets of Minneapolis, Minnesota. And the world, from Hungary to New Zealand to Australia to Paris to London, to big cities, small towns, every village, every hamlet, every neighborhood in this nation have risen up in mainly peaceful protests to simply say enough is enough. Enough is enough, and Black Lives Matter. This Justice in Policing Act represents a bold and clear step forward, but an opportunity at a historic time in American history. As to whether this nation's elected representatives will hear the pain, hear the cries, hear the suffering, hear the outrage, and realize this is not the time for a de minimis backroom Washington political compromise. That this is a moment for bold and courageous action. and the type of action where 20, 40, 60 years hence, history will ask, your children will ask, your grandchildren will ask, where did you stand? Where did you stand? This is a moment not of politics. This is not a moment of black or white. This is a moment of morality. It's a moment of human decency. This act does a number of things. It bans some practices that we all know have to be banned. Chokeholds, no-knock warrants, racial profiling. It created a multi-tiered accountability system, some through the system of the courts in both civil and criminal proceedings, and strengthens the hands of the Justice Department so that it can do its job. It also suggests
Thank you, Mayor Morial.
An accreditation program. So let me just say one last thing, Mr. Chairman, if you'll indulge me, and I'll go back to what I said earlier. I'm asking this Congress, this body, and the United States Senate to recognize the gravity of this moment and the importance of this time, and to stand with the people of this nation to say enough is enough, Black Lives Matter.